For most people, the first thing that comes to mind when you hear the name Rolls-Royce is high-end luxury cars only the rich folks of the world can afford to buy and maintain. And some of you may also know that the real Rolls-Royce is a multinational aerospace and defense company responsible for aircraft engines. However, won't you be surprised to know that Rolls-Royce is working on creating a nuclear reactor to power mining activities on the moon and even Mars? But why are they doing so? Well, we'll find out in just a second. But before that, please subscribe to Futurephile to watch more fascinating videos on futuristic tech. The idea of harvesting a clean and efficient form of energy from the moon has stimulated science fiction and fact in recent decades. Unlike Earth, which is protected by its magnetic field, the moon has been bombarded with large quantities of helium-3 by the solar wind. It is thought that this isotope could provide safer nuclear energy in a fusion reactor since it is not radioactive and would not produce dangerous waste products. The Apollo program's own geologist, Harrison Schmidt, has repeatedly made the argument for helium-3 mining, whilst Gerald Kuczynski at the University of Wisconsin-Madison is another leading proponent. He has created a small reactor at the Fusion Technology Institute, but so far it has not been possible to create the helium fusion reaction with net power output. This has not stopped the search for helium-3 from being a motivating factor in space exploration, however. Apart from the traditional spacefaring nations, India has previously indicated its interest in mining the lunar surface. The use of moon resources was also part of Newt Gingrich's unsuccessful candidacy for the Republican Party's nomination for the US presidency in 2012. Private enterprise is also interested in using fuel from the moon, although possibly by extracting water rather than helium-3. The Shackleton Energy Company envisages providing propellant for missions throughout the solar system using lunar water. According to the Mail this month, Rolls-Royce is developing a nuclear reactor to power mining activities on the moon and even Mars. Earlier this year, the company and the UK Space Agency issued a collaborative research paper on nuclear power alternatives for space rockets. Dave Gordon, president of the firm's defense division, stated that the company is researching how a micronuclear reactor may be used to drive rockets at high speeds while in space. He disclosed that Rolls-Royce is looking into whether that technology might be redeployed to supply energy for drilling, processing, and storage for moon mining. Gordon said nuclear power was the obvious choice of power source, particularly in exploration. The further you go away from the sun, solar is less useful. If you've got a dense, reliable source, it seems credible. So we've been speaking to the UK Space Agency about it. Designs for the microreactor show a device powered by a poppy seed size of uranium coated in silicon and housed in metal and connected to a Stirling engine, allowing the heat to be converted into electricity. Water, which can be turned into rocket fuel, and rare elements and metals, which are utilized in energy production and electrical goods on Earth, are among the valuable natural resources on the moon. Rolls-Royce's efforts could be used to propel rockets while in space at huge speeds, and how that technology could then be redeployed to provide energy for drilling, processing and storage for moon mining, and possibly Mars mining. Dave Gordon further said that this work is possible thanks to Jeff Bezos, Elon Musk and their respective space companies. "If we were having this conversation a couple of years ago, you'd have looked at me in a bemused way," he told the MOS at the Defence and Security Equipment International Arms Fair in London. But now, because of the work that companies like Blue Origin and SpaceX are doing, it suddenly becomes not just credible, but actually, there's a demand there, he further added. Rolls-Royce is the only company on the planet that develops and has stakes in mechanical, electrical and nuclear engineering, and a full end-to-end life cycle of nuclear capability. He also noted that the firm could use its experience in developing nuclear-powered submarines for the Royal Navy for 60 years to apply what it learned to spacecraft, since submarines and spacecraft are somewhat similar. Gordon stated that Rolls-Royce could draw on its 60-year expertise in constructing nuclear-powered submarines for the Royal Navy. He added that submarines were similar to spacecraft as they are non-air-breathing environments, long endurance, super reliable, with a very dense power source. Last week, Britain and the United States declared that they would assist Australia in constructing 8 new nuclear-powered submarines, infuriating China and France. Both based in the United Kingdom, Rolls-Royce and BAE Systems are being considered potential subcontractor candidates. The moon's primary resources include helium-3, a rare material utilized in industries such as nuclear fusion that may power longer space missions utilizing the moon as a refueling stop. It also has water, which can be turned into rocket fuel and may be used to support life, and rare earth metals used in electronics such as cell phones and the latest automobiles. China currently supplies 90% of the world's rare earth metal supply. The nuclear reactor to power mining efforts would only be used in space. It would be launched from Earth as a payload on a normal rocket up to Earth's orbit. Then the reactor system would then be switched on to provide propulsion to travel from Earth's orbit to Mars. A big spaceship can be constructed in Earth orbit in a similar way to the International Space Station, using several normal rocket launches to take everything up there. When completed, the reactor would be used for super high-speed propulsion to Mars. Researchers are still debating how to store and transfer materials obtained on the Moon back to Earth. Another important point of debate and dispute is the sovereignty of nations on the Moon's surface. No nation can claim sovereignty of the Moon under the Outer Space Treaty, signed in 1967, but the US and Soviet Union brought back lunar soil samples in the 1960s and 1970s. The Moon Treaty or Moon Agreement is a multilateral treaty that turns jurisdiction of all celestial bodies, including the orbits around such bodies, over to the participant countries. Thus, all activities would conform to international law, including the United Nations Charter. As of September 2021, it has not been ratified by any state that engages in self-launched human spaceflight, for example the United States, Russia, former Soviet Union, People's Republic of China, since its creation on December 18, 1979, and thus it has little to no relevancy in international law. As of January 2019, 18 states are parties to the treaty. Keep this treaty in mind as Rolls-Royce's project develops further and further. It will come to play a significant role in the entire process and beyond. Nuclear systems have been used on the Moon before. In 1969, the crew of Apollo 12 used a generator to provide the electricity to operate scientific instruments. Indeed, NASA and the European Space Agency, ESA, have expressed plans to put nuclear reactors on the Moon for various purposes, mining, life support, and electricity generation key among them. This is an ambitious plan, and it remains to be seen whether Rolls-Royce can simulate a working example in artificially created moon-like environments. If they are successful, then we can see another aid to SpaceX's moon colonization efforts. So what do you think? Do you think it can work? Or is it too far-fetched to be a reality yet? Let us know what you think of Rolls-Royce plans in the comments below. And if you like this video, you may also enjoy this next video that is shown in the end screen. See you there!